Antipsychotic drugs have a long history of being used among older adults with dementia. They've mainly been used off-label to treat the behavioral and psychosocial symptoms of dementia, such as wandering and aggressive behaviors. However, there's quite an extensive background history of these types of drugs increasing the risk of falls, excess sedation, and even early death among older adults with dementia. As such, there have been a number of very successful campaigns across Canada and in the United States to reduce the use of these medications among people with dementia. So while it's important to highlight this success, we also have to very carefully assess the type of care that takes place after people are taken off of their antipsychotic drug. Living with dementia is challenging for folks living with the condition, their families, and their caregivers. And it might be challenging for homes to consistently implement or use non-pharmacological therapies for dementia, which might then lead to the prioritization of other types of drug therapies. So there are two aims of this current work. The first is to identify whether or not antipsychotic drugs are indeed being switched with other types of drug therapies. And the second aim will be to identify if that switching is associated with other types of downstream health outcomes, such as increased risk of falls and trips to the emergency department. We're going to use de-identified data held at ICES to look at the records of people living in nursing homes with dementia to examine their patterns of medication use over time. So I'd first like to thank the Alzheimer Society of Canada for awarding me this doctoral fellowship to pursue my doctoral research at the Dalla School of Public Health. And I'd also like to thank ICES for providing rich data and methodological expertise to pursue this work. We want to make sure that nursing homes are on the right path for ensuring great quality of care for the residents with dementia.